in the shuffling madness.
Did you see him on MTV? There was a cool special with him.
The Steve Dahl Show is brought to you by Budweiser. For all you do, this Bud's for you. I'm Garry Meier.
Thank you, gentlemen. Incredible, as always. Hi, good evening. Welcome to week number...
Seven.
Hey, dude. Week number seven.
But who's counting?
I am. Until I start making money on this project, I'm counting. Tonight we have some exciting things planned for you. Things like this. You getting a glare on that?
Yeah.
Fan club. Dan, you can come get these. These are your... It's okay, Dan. Don't be afraid.
Why don't you just throw them at him?
No, that's David Letterman's thing. Oh, here comes my coffee, Garry. I actually last... Yeah, coffee. Last week I did drink coffee for the first time. And I couldn't get to sleep till like 4 in the morning. So,
for the first time in your life, or when you started?
For the first time on this show.
Yeah.
So I'm back to beer this week. But we'll say it's coffee.
And a no-spill mug.
Budweiser. You can do that on cable, you know. You can drink beer. Can't you?
Oh, check now.
If you can't, this is coffee. I love Friday nights. So we have this. Getting a glare on that? Fan club. This plan.
Where?
The jungle. That's gonna be weird. We have our famous. Now, is this one or seven? I can never tell when you hold this up.
That's one.
This is one of Dan's cards. The Dan, a professional stagehand, and he knows how to make the professional cards. This is a one.
If this was a cool show, we put smile faces in those zeros.
Yeah, why don't you do that? We'll do our famous 1 minute drill. And our famous 30-second drill. Okay?
Sounds fun to me.
It's going to be a good show.
Right.
A great show. Now, we have our sea monkeys that we did not make last week. Our chia pet. Where do I hold it? We're kind of getting this together, aren't we?
Yep.
That was pretty. I mean, that's kind of like David Letterman would do.
First of all, you don't even have to say, where should I hold it? You just hold it, they pick it up. That's professional.
Yeah?
Yeah. You just hold it up.
Well, sometimes David Letterman says, where should I hold it?
Yeah, but see, we're
mostly
beyond.
To his girlfriend, I think, though.
We're
cheap sex joke. How many minutes into the show? Three?
Not even that.
That could be a new low. So our chia pet is not here because Stan has it at work. He's got it under a grow light.
A grow light?
Yeah.
Right on.
Yeah. So we don't have that, but he says it'll be happening by next week. But we do have the sea monkeys, which I think we should. I think we should have things that grow that we can come and look at every week. So we have a reason to come back.
Okay, then there's no need to book Hervé Villechaize on the show.
Because he won't grow?
No.
I thought maybe some sea monkeys, maybe some of those magic rocks next week. Things that grow. So if you're watching the show every week, there's something growing. Certainly we don't grow as entertainers and performers, so something should grow on the show, right? We'll be back to put the sea monkeys. Now you're supposed to have a you know, like a fish tank, but we only have this. Because it's kind of a low-budget show at this point.
Kind of.
I'm still losing like $500 a week on this thing.
We've already had a cut back.
The band, yeah, the
money.
Band is...
Yeah.
They're now making half of what they made
right
last
now.
Week. Look at them. Look at, they won't even dress up now. Look at Skender. I have never seen John Skender with his hair this down, okay? This is a sign. This dude is saying, oh man, I'm bummed. Look at that. That is down for him. That's he shows no emotion on his face. It's all with his hair. Happy? Sad.
Hold it. We weren't on close on John when you did the happy.
All right. Happy? Sad.
Yeah.
Happy? Happy? Sad. Right?
Right.
You're in black.
Morning.
Olive green pants. Very drab for you. This is what you wear to the show. Usually you change into something more colorful. But not tonight, right? Because of the half off on the salary, yeah. Greg.
Also, we've decided
Greg, this is, you know, to see these guys in black.
Before you move on, didn't we decide that John is trying to look like the lead singer in Rat?
Yeah.
No, really. Are you trying to emulate him?
Yeah.
No, we've watched some videos from Rat, and he looks just like the lead singer now.
Very funny thing happened tonight. John says to me, says, look, no hairspray. I don't want to look too weird. And I said, John, I'm glad you finally have come to your senses, because this is a very normal look for a man in the 80s. No, so I can find nothing to tease you about this week.
Right.
Because you were smart. You stayed away from the hairspray. No, this is a happening 80s cut. Don't worry about it.
Do we have to cut away, or?
Well, we can. I just want to quickly... Greg, stand up. I mean, the only color on you is your pink belt.
I got my notions.
Well, you wore those last week, didn't you?
No, I was going to bring them to show you.
Oh, here, let me have one.
Steve, yep. He also brought the things he talked about last week that he got for Christmas. We'll be looking at those.
Yeah, and what are these?
The Converse All-Stars, but they're gold.
A lot of the guys in the NBA wearing these now? Yeah, man. What?
That's real gold, too. Yeah. We have a Brinks guy out in the lobby.
Actually, NBA guys, these are the size of their booties. They have these hanging from their rearview mirrors. Yeah, man. The only color we see on you tonight, a pink belt and the shoes. Usually you're very colorful, and you've got a Seika shirt on.
Yeah. But that was it. So after I showed you a...
But see, this is the first time ever the band has come here. You got to talk into that.
Oh, yeah. I just wore that just so after I showed you $700 worth of toys, you'd still
I think
go,
you were a man.
Right, you'd go like, well, he must be
he's
a man.
He's into porno.
Right, he's got a porno shirt. Most 11-year-old kids don't even know who Seika was, so I was hoping you'd go, he's a man.
She's still with us.
Is. Yeah. You'd go, well, he must be a man because he has a shirt.
Unless you made a snuff film that I don't know about, but I think she's still with us.
That was my thought.
But the thing is, I have never seen, all right, Roman... Although he's got a Carl Lewis thing happening this week.
I'm just always happy, Steve, just to be a part of the Steve Dahl, Garry Meier entourage. Pay cuts don't bother
Roman
me.
Trying to get at least 10% of the 50% cut back. But let's see the Carl Lewis thing that you're sporting tonight. That's incredible. We're going to need a close-up of that.
From my hairdresser, Anita.
That's a little too close, Ken, don't you think? What are you, on some speed tonight, Ken, or what? Ken was actually going right up one of your nostrils. So, all right, so you, I mean, actually, you're still, well, you make a little bit more
I'm
than the rest
happy.
Of the band because you're the band
happy.
Leader.
No, does he?
I love this job. It's
he makes
life.
A little bit more. You know why? Because he's been with us longer. And like when I say, okay, the band's going to make X amount of dollars, he calls me and goes, shouldn't I make more?
Well, that's the band. What about me?
So, rather than argue with him, I always give him a little bit more. But he's been with us the longest, and he does do
seniority,
organizational work and that sort of stuff, right? Am I right?
At U.S. Steel, if you're there longer, they pay you more.
Exactly.
Good analogy.
He doesn't make that much more. Can I just tell you that? I wouldn't get too worried. But the thing is, so Roman's still semi-happy. He actually changed his shirt. Ed, you always look like a slob. It doesn't, you know, with your now 70s haircut. But I'm just kidding. No, you parted it on the side this week. That's your... He's like up to 73 now with his hair.
Yeah.
Very soon you're going to be with us.
Dry look.
But Skender and Potter never, ever appear on stage or on television or whatever in the clothing they wore to the facility. Mm-hmm. They usually have an outfit to drive to the job, then an outfit for the show, and then an opera show outfit. But tonight, I bet you guys drive home in those outfits. So, I apologize. I guess you're down, but, you know, if the show is going to stay on the air, people are going to have to take pay cuts. Garry and I have not made one penny off of this show.
No, I'm in the hole, just gas money.
Oh, yeah, we've applied for loans, federal loans and stuff. But seriously, we had to give the band a pay cut.
Steve, we're going to break away and try to.
And I appreciate the fact that you even showed up.
Isn't that nice?
Because, you know, when you're making $10 and it goes down to $5, that's got to sting a little bit. But
we'll be right back.
But we appreciate it. Hey, wait a minute. Excuse me, but I'm not quite done yet.
Well, we got an hour.
Well, okay, so relax.
Yeah, but we're going to have a bunch of commercials.
Well, so what?
You want a bunch?
The breaks only last like 10 seconds. Anyway, we're back. I just want to say we appreciate it, and let's hear it for the band.
Hey.
Yeah. Taking a break. We appreciate it, and I know that the people out there appreciate it. Because you guys are keeping the show on the air. Next week, no money. Okay, you said. Okay, now commercials.
Michelob Light. Super premium taste in a less filling beer.
Michelob Light. Oh, yes, you can. Have it all.
Drift into the feeling of a Pleasant Dreams waterbed. This top-quality, all-American-made system, the Geneva, has a mirrored double bookcase headboard, and through Christmas is just $289 complete at all six Pleasant Dreams waterbed stores. For the store nearest you, dial 3124-DREAMS.
It's the feeling that you'll get.